There's a lot of interest these days in uniquely processed coffee, and it's something we're very excited about at Cafe Imports. Coffee processors are experimenting with combinations of varieties and post-harvest handling methods, figuring out what works well together and what works well in their specific location. One of the processing terms we hear a lot at Cafe Imports is anaerobic, and that's what we'll focus on in this video. The term anaerobic translates directly to without oxygen. In coffee, this term means the coffee has gone through a period of time in a low oxygen environment during processing. And that's truly all we can accurately infer from the use of this term. Calling a coffee an anaerobic doesn't tell us the other steps used in fermentation or drying, or whether the coffee was processed as washed, honey, or natural. Nor does it tell us if anything was added to the fermentation tank, including yeast, bacteria, fruit, water, or anything else. Until the industry has more detailed descriptors, the term anaerobic can equally apply to a coffee that went through a 24-hour period sealed in plastic sacks in a more rudimentary approach, or to coffee that spent 10 days in specialized tanks engineered for this very purpose. These two scenarios are very different in their investment and likely in their impact on the final product, but they do technically carry the same name, an anaerobically processed coffee. To showcase anaerobic fermentation, we are at La Chumeca in Tarrazú, Costa Rica, where we will follow Martin Ureña and his son, Emilio, through the making of their delicious anaerobic natural coffees. What we will see in this video is one example of an anaerobic process. We chose this example because it's likely close to what is being envisioned when the term anaerobic is used, and because we love these coffees. It's important, however, to understand that this is just one example of how an anaerobic coffee is made. And as producers and processors continue to innovate, we, as an industry, should remain aware that terminology will also evolve and may not always refer to exactly what we envision. Nevertheless, this video provides an example of a fairly standard way to approach an anaerobic fermentation. Martin and his brother Edgar have rigged up a floating station they use to separate out damaged and unripe cherry before further processing and moving the highest quality cherry to raised drying beds. Because of the extra care in sorting and general care taken with the fruit, the lots produced at La Chumeca, while small in volume, are extraordinarily in their uniformity and quality. Martin recently built a separate processing station to experiment with anaerobic steps in his fermentations using rice fermentation tanks. Martin will select particular small lots processed this way based on their sugar content, described in units called degrees of bricks. He prefers the degrees of bricks to be around 25 degrees, at which point he transports the cherry to the anaerobic processing station. The fermentation tanks are filled with these specially selected and sorted lots of cherry, which are often separated by variety. Once filled with fresh sorted cherry, the tanks are sealed and the coffee cherry ferments in the sealed, low oxygen environment for a period of anywhere from 48 to 72 hours, depending on follow-up Brix readings. This anaerobic step can last up to 10 or even 12 days at other mills. Martin's tanks are sealed by placing the lid firmly on the metal barrel. One-way valves are the only aperture left on the otherwise sealed container. These valves are designed to let gases out, which keeps pressure from building up inside the tank as carbon dioxide and other gases are released from the carbon bonds in the mucilage. The valves restrict oxygen from entering the barrels, maintaining the low oxygen environment. The fermentation is monitored by checking the liquid content of the tanks. The amount of liquid that builds up and the soluble solids, or bricks, of that liquid provides evidence of how far along and how healthy the fermentation process is. Since no water was added to the tanks, this liquid is entirely made up of the juices that oozed out of the coffee fruit cells as the tissue was broken down during fermentation. These, now plausibly termed anaerobic coffees, are left intact from here on out at La Chumeca, dried on tables as naturals under the sun. Note that these coffees could very well be depulped at this point and dried as honeys, creating anaerobic honeys, or they could be depulped and washed, then dried as washed coffees, making anaerobic washed coffees. all of the main processes can be combined with an anaerobic step. La Tumeca, however, chooses to process their coffees as naturals, creating tiny lots of high-quality anaerobic naturals. In the last stage of processing, the coffees are dried on tables, raked carefully by hand several times a day to ensure even drying. Once dried to the desirable level, all naturals, both anaerobic and standard, are rested in grain pro bags before being dry milled and prepared for export.